Hey everyone, welcome back to another episode of James Plays Nuclear Throne. So, this will be the first episode that goes up. We're gonna do a horror. We're gonna do a horror beastkin attempt. So, this will be the first episode that goes up after, my video of defeating the captain of the IDPD as Rogue. That was a monumentous accomplishment, that I'm extremely proud of. It was a lot of work to get that, so I'm really pleased. I'll probably never play Rogue again, and I'm not even joking. Like, I hate that character so much now. I can't stand Rogue. But I'm glad that I have that B-skin so that I don't have to ever play her again. Until I try and get all the crowns for every character. That's gonna be interesting. But regardless, that I think the IDPD captain is the toughest enemy or toughest boss in the game in terms of raw HP, without looping. So, all of the bosses have a certain amount of HP, and then that amount is augmented when you loop. I don't know exactly what the I don't know exactly what the metrics are. I know it increases a bunch the first time you loop, and then increases by less every subsequent loop. So, also with Big Bandit, there's more of him. That's the only boss I can think of. Speaking of Big Bandit. There we go. That's easy. So, the crown has... I remember I was talking about this a while ago. Little Hunter has 140 HP, I think. Big Bandit has 100 something, 150 I want to say, but do not quote me on that at whatsoever. So the throne has 1500, so 1500. But when you destroy the generators, that becomes less. So destroying the generators subtracts from the throne's total health. So you don't have to do 1500 worth of damage to the throne. Now I'm not sure if how much they decrease it, I can't remember. I'm not sure if it's in such a way that you end up doing less damage output in total. So say, like, if the destroying a generator takes off, you know, just for nice round numbers, 100 health of the throne, would it have, like, 50 health itself? That way you're actually doing less damage. Or is it the other way around? A generator with 100 health takes 50 health on its run. That's not actual numbers. That's just made up numbers for the sake of this example. So I'm not sure which one of those it is. However, I do know that the throne itself has 1500 health. And the IDPD captain has 1540 health. It's such a small amount, too. It's almost as if it was, like, to spite you for being like, yes, so this character is harder than the throne. Without, you know... I would say it's harder than the throne. I would say that this achievement was probably the hardest one I've ever done. And I have Melting's B-skin. So, take that as you will. Vis-a-vis Melting being easy or this one being... really hard, but I can tell you that... Oh god, why did I stand in the fire? I can tell you that getting Melting's Beast Skin was not a simple task. If you're interested in seeing me do another, you know, run of that, I already have it, but, you know, getting it again, per se, let me know, and I can do something in regards to that. No matter what happens, I guarantee that it will not be as bad as getting Rogue's B-skin, so I'm open to most anything at this point. Do I have Oh, I do have Euphoria. I took that. I need to pay more attention to this run. Nailed it. They give you more rats if you get them while they're still sleeping. I don't know if you know that. Bouncer SMG. You keep the double shotgun. Double shotgun's really good for the junkyard dog, the big dog. Because you can't miss, so all the pellets land, and it also hits his little bullet things. I'm gonna blow up all these cars as a preventative measure. Oh, he was still alive. I did not know that. Alright, well that's unfortunate. There goes my strong spirit. So, I mean, beating this guy without getting hit won't be too challenging. The next area may be interesting. Although I found that on the crystal caves, I either... Oh, well, at least I got some health back. I either, like, flawless it, in dungeon terms. You know, don't get hit, or I get hit a whole bunch and probably die. There's no in-between. Thankfully, I have scarier face. One of my favorite enemies that scarier face affects, it affects all of them in the game. Every single enemy. But my favorite effect it has is being able to kill those crystals in two bolts instead of one. It really makes a big difference. Right. Oh, that was relatively small. Okay. So I guess we did well on that one. Impact wrists, because it's so fun. And I need a couple fun mutations, you know, after the very serious attempt at, successful attempt. I have to say it, Rogue's Beast game. I had to take, you know, exactly the you know, optimum mutation. So, was that an auto crossbow? I think it might be. It's not running. It is. Well. And, oh my gosh. Praise be. Praise be. This has just gone from good to excellent. Health. We've got nice mutations. Did we even check the weapons chest on this floor? I think we checked for the rats. The worst thing is just accidentally having hostile horror pop up in the middle of the floor when you're not expecting him. Which is... I feel like I explained everything multiple times, but I'm just going to do this one. It's when you skip two rat canisters. On the third one, it will be a hostile version of horror. And that's how you unlock horror. By the way, if you like me explaining things, let me know. Or if you like me not explaining things, also let me know. I'm very open to feedback to improve the videos as per what you, the viewers, like to see. Oh, that was bad. Completely forgot I had the Gatling Slipper, too. Oh, funny thing about the nuke launcher. While I was doing research for the rogue, I'm gonna stop talking about rogue eventually. Don't worry. Eventually. While I was doing the research, I found that the nuke launcher does 100. That's a mimic. 100 damage if you like nail a guy with it. Like if optimum hit, heart of the explosion, it does 100 damage. There's a whole bunch of guys. So with the captain having 1500 HP, 1540, that means you would have to hit him, you know, simple matter, 15 times with his nuke launcher. 15 nuclear bombs, quote unquote, bombs, to kill this enemy, this boss. I thought that was like kind of a sobering. So that's what you're not gonna take it. It's a bit of a sobering sort of, what's the word for, like, a metaphor? Is it a metaphor? No, it's not a metaphor, but it's like a metric? Like a thing you measure? Yeah, metric. That's a pretty sobering metric, with which to measure the captain. Oh, God. Oh, no! Please! Why? Get out of the corner, I say to myself. This went from not bad to, oh god, why? From like 0 to 50. 17 milliseconds. Okay. I feel like the labs always throws me. Because you'll have really good weapons for the level that's before and after it, like the Frozen City. Your weapons will be like perfect for it. And, you know, here, your weapons will be perfect for it. But then they will be awful for fighting all those little, I think they're called freaks, for fighting all those little guys in the labs. Stay safe, don't get hit. Get those shells. Just to hit him. These guys have 100 something health. I've been spending too much time on the wiki. The nuclear throne wiki, that is. And yet, I still can't remember the names of all these enemies. Isn't that funny? Get you. 7 health, that's okay. And we have our strong spirit. As long as we have our strong spirit, I'm okay with the situation. We're gonna take plutonium hunger. A bunch of good ones, but we've already got, you know, not gonna take the laser brain when we already have an auto crossbow. And a lot of, some of those mutations I definitely would have taken. Like if I got that choice, you know, as my first or second mutation. Hyperlauncher. I'll stick with the Gatling sword. If those had been my first or second mutation choices, I would have chosen differently. But because of the mutations we already have, you know how it goes. Let's change. That's the last one? Yes, it is. Alright. So, we're up for throne fight. No melee weapon, but we're fine. Yo. You know how rarely I see this weapon? It's so fun, too. Oh, God, I love this. I love this. I better not fucking die. Like, I would be so upset with myself. If it's just like, yeah, heavy auto crossbow. Oh, nope, you're dead. You can't use it. I would really not be okay with that. Probably gonna use our horror beam on the throne. Since the horror beam, here I go explaining things again. Oh my god. The horror beam, the way it works is you get, all the rads you miss are gone forever. But all the rads you hit with are dropped again when the enemy dies. So, I'm using my rads as ammunition. Nice. So, the ones that I fired after it died are gone for good. Which was a significant portion of them, actually. It did a lot of damage, I don't care. Oh, why did I move into his shot? Gross expenditure of ammunition. God, this thing's just so friggin' powerful. I love it. Okay, we're not even at level 9 yet. One more thing about the rogue fight. In the video, I only show starting with me going to at the throne. At the beginning of. Oh god, no. Focus, pay attention. Stop talking about rogue. No, so I'm here, and then he proceeds to resume talking about rogue. I was at the. Why? I started the video at right when I went to into the throne fight. Yeah, this is fine. So, right, you know, the beginning of the video. If you haven't seen it, you should. You really should go watch it. It's wonderful. No commentary? Okay. Got him. And help. No commentary. Except right after I kill it. But I am awful at getting distracted. Anyways, I went to the jungle on that run, which is interesting because the jungle is really hard and is considered to be like a run killer by no one except for myself. But you know, it's a very hard area. So you know, it's interesting, or at least I think it's interesting. If you don't think it's interesting, it's, you know. Oh, he's gonna run me over. Ammo. hey, we got our, we lost our strong spirit. I didn't even notice that. Yes, I can English. Smart gun. I feel like the smart gun's in the wrong game. Which is a weird, oh god. Which is a weird thing to say. But, like, you think about it, is it, like, it doesn't work in this game. But in, say, like, a different but similar sort of shooter, like, you know, enter the gungeon I'll mention again. Still no ultra. It would work quite well, like an auto-targeting weapon. But here, it's almost useless, because you're usually behind cover and you kind of peek out or whatever. If you're like me, or you're just, like, you know, sleep cycles and you're just amazing at dodging. Okay. Plan not die is in full effect. I really hate the IDPD. I used to not hate the IDPD as much. And then they made me hate them. They gave me no choice. Oh, I can use my beam now. Oh, is that a... It is. I have to. I can't not. How far do we have to get in order to get... Hypercrystal. So, labs... Hang on. Let me think about this. Labs. Frozen City. Then... Hypercrystal, and we have to kill the Hypercrystal. Yeah, we can do that without the Gatling Slugger. Yeah, we can do that no problem. Alright, Ultra Mutation. It's between these two. This one, like, they explode little bits of the beam. I think that would go well with... This is the longest I've ever spent thinking about a mutation. This would go well with impact wrists. This would go well with me, like, getting the hell out of dodge. This, how it works is... Here I go explaining. I'm going to take this one, but I'll explain the other one. So the portals appear earlier when there's a collective amount of health on the floor. Oh, god, why? That was, like, all my health. Just... So when there's only a certain amount of health left, like, between, like, you add up the health of all the enemies, and I don't know how much it is, because, obviously, why would I? Can I just, like, freaking beat these guys? Okay, I have one of those. Is that the van? I might have to take... Oh, no, that's a grenade. It took me a second to realize that that was, in fact, a grenade. I might just take the Gatling Slugger. All these guys are dead already. The heavy auto-crossbow is amazing and beautiful, but I have one of those. But it's not working for our purposes. You know what I really want to do one day? Is... You have YV with his throne butt, which is like double it. You right click and you fire 4 majiggers instead of 2 when you normally right click with YV. And fire a super plasma. 2 shots instead. Fire a super plasma cannon shot. Right clicked. With YV. That's like life goals right now. Energy. Nice. Okay. Frozen City. Let's go. I should use my laser beam. Oh, I forgot that it... I keep forgetting that. It blocks shots. See, I... Why? Okay. The horror beam blocks bullets. Like, it... It's like a blood explosion technique. That guy is still out there. There we go. Oh, wow. I thought... Wait, is that another one? I thought I killed him. Okay, there's his body. Oh, it is another one. That should solve that problem permanently. Hold the machine gun. There we go. Alright, first one. Done. It isn't Frozen City, it's the junkyard. I'm being slow. Still, junkyard's fine. If you don't know what I'm talking about, that's fine. Neither do I. I'm just gonna pop one of those in there. Assassin. Oh, wow, that was... Alright, let's, I gotta sneeze again. I'm good. What? No, I'm good. Oh god, this. I wish there was just a little thing here so I could shoot. Oh, well, hey. Thank you. That solved my dilemma. About a red chest. Fight with Junkyard Dog. That's a lot of snipers. Like an excessive number of snipers. Oh, and that's the van. Oh, hi there. Okay. I am utterly amazed that I did not take damage in that brawl. Don't die? Is that... No, there's still more. Oh, my shot is still going. That's... Health? Anyone? Anyone? Ultra Shovel. I have been told the Ultra Shovel is, like, the best weapon. So, I'm gonna do that. The Super Plasma Cannon was really fun. Now, the trick will be to not die. In one hit. That was terrifying. Okay, so... Ultra Weapons uses rads. Three hits to hit that guy, I don't know. I've never used this weapon before. So I'm still, like, assessing its... Oh, that's the hyper crystal right there. So we're just gonna go this way for a little while. Hey, a health chest. It's just what I wanted. How did you know? Get out of here. Okay, so we just need to beat this thing, and then we're good. This is where I really wish I had... Oh. Oh, God. Are they just gonna, like, fight it out? I guess not. What if I just do that? Ultra Shovel also... I guess I should just get in here. Ultra Shovel also needs rads in order to fire. And there goes all my rads. That, what? Oh, that's it. Those are my things. Hey, look at that. All right. So, I mean, we're going to keep playing, obviously. But that means Chicken is the last V-skin to get. And then I don't know what I'm going to do. This is really interesting. I mean, this is what my third attempt. I haven't done any off-camera attempts on this, by the way. So this is my third attempt. You've seen them all. Or third, fourth. It hasn't been many. Attempt at getting Horror's B-Skin. I'm not gonna say it's easier, but it's totally easier. So I lied. I still haven't... Oh, that rate of fire is really good. I didn't notice that until now. Yeah, I'm really starting to like the Ultra Shuttle. And I'm okay with having not taken the Super Plasma Cannon. And, yeah, we're gonna do that. You know what I should have done? Or what would synergize well with this anyways, is the double rad capacity thing. That would have been really good. I'll have to remember that for next time. So yeah, this is my third attempt. I got the B-skin. So, well, I mean, let's see how far we can get, because we need to unlock hard mode. This is a pretty good loop. Not the best one I've ever had. Maybe. Maybe it is. I don't know. We need to unlock hard mode in order to get Chicken's B-skin. I've heard that hard mode is, like, people really don't like it. It's basically like you start the game and it's as if you've already looped. That it's like, you know how there's like different enemies and stuff like that. Is this the little hunter fight? I really hope it isn't. Oh god, why did I go next to you? But anyways, we need to unlock hard mode, which you do by defeating the throne a second time, which I have not done yet. Who knows, maybe we'll do it on this run. I'm really liking the enemies explode with radiation upon death. Health. Okay, good. Of course, I, like, end up sacrificing a ton of health just to get it in the first place. Down there needs to, like, freaking chill. God, that was... Oh, I guess we're going to a crown vault then. Sure, why not? Golden bazooka. Problem with getting golden golden whoopins. That's a new one. Golden whoopins. Not really. Well... Yeah, we'll take this one just because. Problem with getting, or trying to get golden weapons, is that they only spawn either... Oh, hi. Well, that was fast. Anyways, back to the topic at hand. Golden weapons. They only spawn, the good ones anyways, only spawn on a loop. Right? So, by the time you've looped, you've gotten, like, all the really good whoopins that you want. Like, me right now, for example, with the Gatling Slugger and the Ultra Shovel. Oh, that's the... Yeah. So, to take a golden weapon, golden whoopin, is a serious downgrade. Like, you basically have to go with one weapon for... the whole time. Now, until you... Assuming you're close enough to the portal to pick up a weapon again, but essentially it's like you go down to one weapon, because whatever the golden weapon is will be effectively useless, right? So, it's not that they're hard to get to, it's just that unless you're really specifically going for one, you know, you would never get it. And if you're specifically going for one, you may as well just go to YV's Mansion. Because the ones you can get from not YV's Mansion aren't even that much better. I thought we were only supposed to get ammo chests. I mean, I'm not complaining. Oh, labs. Labs. Oh, and, mini ammo chests, which is what those things are called, they expire faster, on a loop. I didn't know that, until now. Remember the first time I got this far, it was with steroids, which is a beautiful character. Hunk of a man. It was with steroids, so, that was the farthest I'd ever gotten at that point, and I unlocked his bee skin, and I didn't even know what you had to do to unlock his bee skin, and I think that was the first one I got, one of the first ones I got. So, steroids will always have a special place in my heart, and after this, I think, after we get, you know, finish this run, next episode, we'll probably do some steroids runs. If we don't make it to... I hear a van. Oh, there's the van. Is he gonna... Oh, no, he's not gonna make it. Alright, I'm gonna ignore them till later. That's a super crossbow. No. Let me think about that. After this is palace, and then I don't have eagle eyes or anything. Can I hit that here? I can. There is a plasma minigun around. Oh, there it is. That was surprisingly terrifying and yet also painless. All right, pardon the sniffling. I think it's allergies. I hope it's allergies. I mean, in comparison to it being a cough. This is gonna be interesting because I have to dodge those, but like, you know, I get the explosions. That explosion, the rad explosion, that I don't have to dodge. Yeah, we are gonna take that ammo. That's a van. I kind of want to, like, spawn the portal and then get that. Is that it? That's the portal down there, I think. Yeah, take that. Oh, we were full on shells anyways, and that's the only ammo that matters. Okay. So one more level of this, then fight the throne. We're all good. Oh god, that was... Oh, wow. Whatever you do, don't run out of rads. Don't die, come on, don't... Don't die. Oh, not at... Oh... You know what? That's not sad. That's happy. We got the bee skin. We killed by him. We almost looped again. This is one of the best runs I've had. So I will see you next time. We're probably going to do a steroids run or something like that. But thank you for watching, and tune in next time.